Hey guys, welcome back to Ben's Reptile World. Today we will be reviewing the top reptiles for beginners, at least in my opinion.
Fly me to the moon, let me play.
Number one has got to be the crested gecko. The crested gecko, they're just so cool. The way they move, their colors, they jump, the superpower they have to hold onto glass. It's just so cool. And they're so easy to take care of. You can either feed them rapashi with a calcium supplement in them, like this, or you could just feed them Pangea. Pangea is literally the best food in my opinion because of how good it smells to them, and they just love it. Now, crested geckos, they are arboreal, so they do need a vertical setup. And when you get them, you want to make sure you quarantine them. Like, simply put them in a plastic shoebox with air holes, with paper towel, so you can monitor how they're pooping and stuff like that. But other from that, yeah, that's why they're the number one on the list. Now, starting off at number two, the leopard gecko. Now, the leopard gecko is not my favorite. It's because I don't really like desert species that much. But it's pretty much the easiest desert species you can have, just because of their care is pretty simple, except how you feed them. That's really the only point that matters. Like, you need to make sure that when you feed them that they don't have, when they have enough calcium so they can actually live, or else they'll go into a calcium shock, which is essentially a seizure for lizards. And just one thing to keep in mind, when you get a leopard gecko, you do need like a basic 10-gallon tank and a heat source and a bunch of hides, because they're really just gonna hide all day. You're never really gonna see them at all, except when you feed them. And their diet's really just crickets or dubia roaches.
Bum, bum, bum. Ba-dum, ba-dum.
Number three, the corn snake. Now, if you've gotten your parents to allow you to get a snake, you gotta go for the corn snake. They come in such a wide variety of patterns and all that stuff, and they don't get that big. They live about 10, 15 years old, and they don't eat mice. You can literally just feed them insects. And other from that, their care and their cage is pretty simple. You just need shavings or like a light fluffy substrate and a whole bunch of places to hide and foliage, because they are from forests, so they do like to hide under rocks and in holes and all that good stuff. Number four, bearded dragon. Now, the bearded dragon is cool in many ways because they are literally living dinosaurs. They grow giant, almost over a foot, and they're really simplistic, except for their diet and stuff like that. But just saying, when you buy one, they're going to be about 3 inches, and they're not going to stay small. They're going to grow huge, and they're gonna need a 50-gallon tank, which is gonna take up a lot of space if you have a small house. And you also need to make sure you are aware of how much their food's gonna cost, because they do eat vegetables, and you don't want them to have pesticides, any of that bad stuff. And you just wanna aim for really good organic leaves, like spinach, pepper, kale, anything like that. And on occasion, you will be feeding them dubia roaches dusted with calcium powder so they have enough color in them.
I like to dream. Yeah, yes, right between the sun machine. On a cloud.
Starting off, number six, ball python. Now, the ball python, it's a pretty good reptile. They are really cool. They can come in piebald, which is my favorite. There's all kinds of new morphs coming out of them, and they're really, really interesting. But the only thing is they do require frozen-thawed mice, and you cannot feed them insects. And they will, they're probably one of the biggest reptiles on this list. And they can be pretty big, they can be feisty, and they're not really good as a first snake, just because they will grow big and they will eat mice. But occasionally, you would feed them once a week, frozen mice, thawed, of course, and you just want to make sure that they're pooping right and they're not regurgitating their food. And one thing to take note on, do not feed live mice, and I mean do not. If you leave a mice in the cage and then you leave, you'll come home to a dead snake. Because ball pythons, they'll ball up and sleep. The rats or mice that you feed will literally gnaw on them until they get into the snake and will bleed out and die.
Money! 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 Money!
Number six, not really a reptile, but it's gotta be the Pac-Man frog. Now, the Pac-Man frog is very small, doesn't grow to be that big, probably like a silver dollar size. They are very colorful, and they do not look like Pac-Man, although they do come in yellow colors. They don't need a huge cage, you just need very moist soil, substrate, anything. Minimum, I would say 5-gallon tank, horizontal. They are not arboreal. They will burrow under the substrate. But something to know is that they will eat pinkies, which are basically freshborn mice. Now, you want them to be frozen, thawed, because they do not handle well with solid foods. On occasion, a whole pinky will last them almost a week and a half of their diet. And you can feed insects, although I don't recommend it because they can have issues releasing the feces after.
We got a number one victory royale. Yeah, Fortnite, we about to get down.
Get down.
10 kills on...
Number seven. The chubby frog. Now, no, they aren't chubby, although they can grow pretty big depending on how much you feed them. They can grow almost the size of my head or a full softball size. Now, out of all the reptiles, this is probably one that will not move. You will not see it move at all. It needs a 5-gallon tank, and it will literally live in one hole. You just spray it, it'll drink through its skin, and the food comes to it. So you literally just dust an insect with calcium powder, take the tongs, dangle it in front of their face, and they're gonna love you for the rest of your life. They live very long, and they love to eat. That's why they get the name chubby frog, or tomato frog, as they call them. They don't really come in a whole lot of colors, except for your typical reddish-brown. But along from that, that's pretty much it for the chubby frog. It's a pretty simple reptile. Well, amphibian. I don't know why I put it on the reptile list. I'm gonna rethink my life.
Somebody once told me...
Number eight, the Euromastix. Now, they may look like a bearded dragon to you, but they are completely different. They need almost half the size of a bearded dragon's full-grown cage would be, which is a simple 20-gallon. It's typical sand, lots of ledges to hide under. They will hide under them. In the wild, they would go into a crevice, and they have a spiny tail, so they'll fling that tail in front of them, so the whatever's trying to eat them cannot get to them. They will not do that to you in captivity, though. The interesting part of their diet, though, is they don't eat vegetables, they don't eat insects, they don't eat mice, they eat birdseed. Yep, birdseed. Now, they are, since they're a desert species, in the wild, they would eat, like, dried up plant seeds, anything they could find that was seedy, that, like, the high fat content makes up their diet. They love it. Other from that, yeah, they're pretty much number two. A lot easier to care for than a bearded dragon, and they're pretty pretty cool. They come in a whole lot of colors. Like, sometimes they can be rainbow, sometimes they can just be standard brownish. But yeah, easily one of the coolest reptiles on the list. At number 9, the day gecko. Now I know this looks like the Geico gecko, but it is not whatsoever similar.
With a snap of my fingers!
When you go on a Geico commercial, you might see like a car crash and a gecko just chilling there. No. This is very fast. You want a vertical cage, easily 12 by 12 by 18. They don't really come in a whole lot of colors if in the day gecko species. If you want to get a neon day gecko, they're like this big and they're literally faster than the Flash. I mean, Sonic could not outrun this thing. They're not very handleable when they're that small, but when they're big, like this day gecko here, they're pretty big. They can grow about almost like the size of a standard
hot dog
almost, and you still feed them a Apache or a Pangea. They are not from where the crested geckos are, even though they might look like they are. They're from regions of Puerto Rico. And the only thing to know is you do not want to handle these things because their tail will fall off, and if they're overhandled, patches of their skin will release from their body, which is not a pretty sight. Now, but other from that, they're pretty cool, except they can be fast and they can lose almost every single part of their body and regrow it. But anyway, thanks for watching. This is Ben's Reptile World, and I'll see you on the next one.
Hello, thanks for watching my video. It's a proven fact that generosity makes you a happier person. So if you're generous enough to click that like and subscribe button and turn on all notifications, then thank you. Also, you better...
Oh yes, oh yes, hit it, daddy, hit it, oh yeah, go, go.